Good morning, thank you for coming. This presentation is oriented to web developers and in general people interested in knowing more details about new HTTP headers that we have in browsers, in general, in Chrome, Firefox, and so on. This is the agenda. This is the main headers that we have seen. One related with strict transport security, another for public key pinning, and the last one for content security policy. We go on details in this one. The first one I will comment is related with strict transport security. Strict transport security is a new header for browsers that where, for example, where you make a request for your site, the first request most of the time is in an encrypted way, and this header will provide is secure the first request. When you make the first request over your site, this header provides more security for this request. Basically, what is that is avoid man-in-the-middle attacks that try to intercept the initial HTTP request. And for example, try to minimize the risk where for SSL stripping. SSL stripping is an attacker technique for that. The idea of this attack is get the initial request that is in an encrypted way and obtain the control of the user of the session user, for example. Basically, this header is when we can test this header. For example, if we see in the response headers the strict transport security with mass age and the time where for expiration. This we can see that this is working in this side. For example, if we have an Nginx server, we can configure in an easy way this header. Basically, what we can do is add the strict transport security and add a specific attribute like mass age, inclusive domains, and so on. For example, the mass age tells the user agent how long to cache the settings in the browser. And if this time expires, will delete from the browser. And the inclusive domains tells the user agent of the browser to include any subdomains where when the user make a request, you can include subdomains for this site. For testing this, we have internally Chrome. It has net internal tools, and it has a specific menu called HSTS, where we can test, we can input a domain name and query this header, the presence of this header in the site. We can see that with attributes like static HSTS domain, static HSTS inclusive domains, and so on. Regarding browser supports, at this moment, last versions of Firefox, Chrome, Safari, Opera supports these headers. It's very well supported by the major versions in browsers. Another interesting tools that is a complement for these headers is using, for example, this at level client in the browser. We can use a plugin, specific plugin for making for redirects the user always to the HTTPS site of the version of the site. Sometimes the site is configured for connecting with HTTP and HTTPS, and if we want the iOS navigate over in a security way, we can use this plugin for doing this. This plugin is available from Chrome, Opera, Firefox, and it's available for stand. The next header I will comment is related with certificate pinning. This header is related with certificate pinning, and basically what it does is test the browser how to how is relationate the public fingerprinting with the with a specific public domain. Basically, it's a security mechanism which allows HTTPS websites to receive impersonation by attackers using misissue or otherwise fraudulent certificates. Basically, what this does is avoid the fake or impersonate certificates. This header minimizes the man-in-the-middle attacks by pinning certificates, and this header, the functionality is using pin basis. The pin is saved by the browser when the user make the first request. The pin is saved in the browser, and in the next request, use this pin to verify the public key that is safe in the certificate. In this way, we can check that the certificate has not been altered. It's a way for assuring that the certificate is not altered, is not impersonated by other user. For configuring this header, for example, in Nginx, we can use the public key pins header, where we have to configure two attributes. We have to configure pin SHA256 hash. This hash, we can obtain the hash from the public certificates of our site. This hash, we can obtain this hash for example with an OpenSSL command from our public certificate site, and we need another pin for as backup. We need two pin, one for the public content, and another if the first is failing, we can use another for as backup information. We can also use inclusive domains and the message for the specific the time that the browser is catching this header. These are the steps that we can follow for implement this header in our site. Basically, what we have to do is first decide which certificate we are going to pin. It has to be a certificate with public key. In the second step, create the hashes, the pin hashes for the public keys. In the third step, go to the site and add the header in our server, depending what server we're using, Nginx, Internet Information Server, Apache, depending what server we are using, we have to vary the configuration. And for testing this, if we want to test this header, we can use also the Chrome internal net internal tools and query our domain to verify that the pins are stored correctly in our browser. Basically, what we have to do is go to the tool that has Chrome and verify that we are in the property in dynamic is SPKI hashes. We is storing the hashes of the public certificate. We see this theoretically is okay. Regarding browser supports, actually only Firefox, Chrome and Opera supports this header. It's a disadvantage, but I think that in next versions, I think that, for example, Safari, I don't know, but probably Edge or Internet Explorer probably support this header in the future. For testing this header, also we have specific plugins. For example, in Firefox, we have a plugin called Pin Patrol. Pin Patrol checks the previous header, the related with street transport security, and this related with public key pinning. Basically, this is a plugin that provides information about the request that the user has made in the browser and shows information related with the expiration time of the header in the browser. Shows information also if the header supports subdomains and in the case of public key pinning, header show information about the pins of the header that are stored in the browser. And the last one I will comment is CSP. CSP is helps to detect and mitigate data injection, cross-site scripting, attacks, client hijacking, JavaScript code injection, and so on. Basically, what it does is load everything from the same origin. For configure this header in Nginx, for example, we can use content security policy and specify what are the content that we have to load in the page. With the self keyword, we can to specify the content of this type can only be loaded from the same origin. We have expressions for this for checking this header. We have different expressions depending what we want to do with our site. We have wildcard expressions, the self for allow with the same origin, none for deny all access, and different values and different expressions depending what we want to specify in this header. For checking this header, also we have many sites. For example, CSP Evaluator. This is a plugin for Chrome. It's a tool developed by Google. We have also other sites like CSP Amazon. With this tool, we can generate a content security policy header based in the expressions that we have seen in the previous slide. And finally, conclusions. Basically, what it provides these headers in the case of HSTS assures that the browser would open an encrypted HTTP request to your domain. In the case of the public key pinning header, assures that nobody can change your certificate and make a manually made attack. And for example, we have more headers. For example, if we want to provide enable web browser self cross-site scripting attack protection mechanisms and another protection against another client hijacking attacks, we can use also more headers like XSF protection, XFEN options, X content type options, and so on. For testing all this, we have the classical command curl with the head option. We can check, obtain all the headers that provides a specific domain. And finally, commenting that if we are developing in Node.js application, we have specific modules for adding all this information in our site. For example, the Helmet and the Kraken.js framework provides has specific modules for adding all the headers, all these headers to our site. And finally, reference and the size for the plugin and other sites that we can use for testing the headers of our site. Mozilla Observatory and that's all. Thank you.